Good afternoon, everyone. So today we are going to start our second unit, that is Leadership in Educational Administration. You know, there are different theories of leadership and models that have been propounded to provide the explanation on the leadership phenomenon and to help the leaders influence followers towards achieving the organizational goals. So the actions of human beings in society that are determined by their associations with different organizations, and every organization has its own purposes, every organization has its own objectives. So the achievement of these objectives, they largely depend upon the cooperative efforts of individuals and the competence of the leader. That's very important here because we are discussing the leadership here. So the competence of the leader is very important. And many times in organizations, they have failed when either their leaders have been of low caliber or there have been a lack of cooperative efforts among its members and the objectives of the organizations that are not essential and good for the society. So what basically the leadership is, so we can define that leadership is an art of motivating a group of people to act towards achieving a common goal. So we can say that it's an ability to inspire others, and effective leadership is that is based upon the ideas which inspire others to act as the leader wants them to act. So in a nutshell, we can say that a leader is the inspiration and the director of action. So he only is the person in the group that possesses the combination of personality and leadership skills that makes others want to follow his or her directions. So there are some people, who seem to be naturally endowed with the leadership abilities than others, but some people can learn to become the leaders by improving the particular skills. So if we look at a history, history is full of those people having no previous leadership experience. They have stepped in the crisis period and directed others to follow their suggested course of action. So we can also say then that the leadership is the process of influencing the behavior of others to work willingly for achieving the predetermined goals. So it is indispensable for the successful functioning of an organization and attainment of its goals and objectives as well. Leadership, it transforms potential into the reality. So it is an ultimate act which brings, success, which brings all the potential status in an organization and its people. So achievement of organizational goals very much depend on how effectively, leadership is exercised in any organization. And organizational leaders are the key figures here who can change the, work climate so that all the employees are motivated to work hard with the results so that the goals can be achieved. Now, most of the students, they get confused between the leadership and the educational leadership. As we said, that leadership is an art of motivating a group of people to act towards achieving a common goal. So educational leadership is a process of enlisting and guiding the talents and energies of teachers, pupils, and parents towards achieving a common educational aim. So this is the basic difference between the leadership and educational leadership. Now we'll discuss about the nature of leadership. How is the nature of the leadership? The leadership in education means directing the activities of those who are engaged in the training of minds towards the achievement of the goals that are set by those persons who have, organized themselves for the same. So as far as the nature of the leadership is concerned, I would say that first is the management or the managing. This is very important. Leadership is essential for managing. The ability to lead effectively is one of the keys to being an effective manager or a leader, because the leader, he or she has to combine resources and lead a group to achieve the objectives. That's why managing is very important as far as leadership is concerned. Second is motivation. Leadership and motivation, these two terms are closely interconnected. And by understanding motivation, one can, appreciate better what people want and what they act as they do. So a leader can encourage or dampen workers' motivation by creating a favorable or unfavorable working environment in the organization. Next is the followership. The essence of the leadership is followership. And in other words, we can say that it is the willingness of people to follow a person that makes that person a leader. Moreover, people, they tend to follow those whom they see as providing a means of achieving their desires, their needs, and their wants. As far as the values are concerned, you know, leadership is to be concerned about the values, because the followers, they learn ethics and values from their leaders, and leaders are the real teachers, I would say, of ethics, and they can reinforce the ideas. So it's very important for leaders to make the positive statements of ethics if they are not hypercritical. Demands and ambitions. You know, the leader must coexist with the subordinates or followers, and they must have a clear idea about their demands, about their ambitions. This creates a sense of loyalty. This creates a sense of trust in subordinates for their leaders. You would also can mention here that, you know, leadership involves an unequal distribution of power between the leaders and the group members, because group members, they are not powerless. They can shape group activities in some ways, but still the leader will usually have more power than the group members. So here I would just stress again here upon the motivation that leaders, they can influence the followers. They can influence the behavior in some ways. In fact, we can say the leaders, you know, they influence the workers either to do ill or well for the company. So the leader must be able to empower and motivate the followers to the cause. Next is the style of the leadership. You know, leadership styles, you know, refers to the leader's behavior towards the group members or the members who are working in its organization. So the behavioral pattern which the leader, you know, reflects in his role as a leader is often described as a style of leadership. So a leadership style is the result of the leader's philosophy, leader's personality, value system, and experience as well. So it also depends upon the types of the followers and the organizational atmosphere prevailing in that enterprise. There are different types of leadership styles, and leadership, you know, is based on the authority. So the first type is that autocratic leadership. You know, this type of leadership relies on the coercion, and its style is, you know, paternalism, you can say, that's command and compliance. So the autocratic leaders, they just, you know, give orders which must be obeyed and which must be obeyed by the subordinates. So here the leader determines the policies for the group without even consulting them, and he does not give the detailed information about the future plans as well, but he just simply tells, you know, what immediate steps they must take. So this is the type of the autocratic leadership and how the leader behaves in when he adopts the autocratic leadership. Next is the democratic leadership. Now, this style of leadership uses the legitimate powers. And here, a leader is kind of a democratic, and he usually gives the instructions only after consulting with the group. So he sees to it that policies are worked out in groups, in group discussions, and with the acceptance of the group. So this is the main difference between the autocratic and the democratic. Here, no freedom is given to the, you know, subordinates, and everything is being hidden for the by the leader. But here, here the leader discusses with the subordinates first, and then he proceeds. Next is the laissez-faire leadership, and here the leadership allows the maximum freedom to the followers. And that's why it's called as the laissez-faire leadership. And here the leader, he gives his employees a high degree of independence in the working operations. And in this style, the leader, you know, completely abdicates his leadership position to give all responsibility, you know, to most of the people who are working in his organizations. And he distributes his work actually, you know, to the people entrusted to him. So here, the leader just, you know, limits his authority to maintain the contact to the group with persons outside the group. So this is also called as the permissive style of leadership. Next is the paternalistic leadership, and under this style of leadership, the leader here assumes that his function is paternal, or we can say it's fatherly. So here, the leader, he or she works to help, guide, even protect and even keep his followers happily working together, as just like as the members of the family. So here the leader provides them with the good working conditions and even the employee services. So this mode of leadership, we can say that it produces the good and quick results if the followers are highly educated and have a sincere desire to go ahead and perform with the responsibility. So this was all about the leadership, its nature, and the styles of leadership. So this is all for today. I'll see you next week again. Till then, take care and stay safe.